Normally, when we think about cloning, we think about cloning in this sense. So let's say that we've got a baby and it's just so cute that we want two of them. So we can go and clone a baby. Well, this isn't exactly what we're talking about when we talk about cloning in the scientific sense. Normally, what that means scientifically is, let's say that I've got a cell and there's a certain gene, let's call it gene A for now, and I want to clone that gene. So how do I go about cloning gene A? Well, the first step is to isolate the messenger RNA from the gene of interest. So if we have the messenger RNA, what we need to do is we need to convert it into DNA. So if we add reverse transcriptase, which is an enzyme that will go and actually create DNA from RNA, we'll end up with something known as complementary DNA. Now, complementary DNA, and that's what the C stands for, is basically the complementary DNA sequence to the mRNA sequence. Now, keep in mind that the complementary DNA only contains exons, so the introns have already been spliced out. And we talked about introns and exons in an earlier video. So next, what we have to do is we take this cDNA, this complementary DNA, and now what we want to do is we want to amplify it. We want to create lots and lots of the complementary DNA so that we can have plenty of cDNA to work with. So in order to do that, we have to take this complementary cDNA and transform it into a plasmid. Now, what does transform mean? Well, what it basically means is that we're taking the complementary DNA and we're basically putting it into a plasmid. So we're going to transform it into a plasmid. And this plasmid is going to contain antibiotic-resistant genes. So antibiotic-resistant genes. And we'll talk about why that's important in just a second. So now that we have this plasmid, we want to actually infect bacteria with the plasmid. So we want to put it into bacteria. And once it's in the bacteria, what we want to do is we want to actually add antibiotics to the culture of bacteria. So we're going to add antibiotics. And since the plasmid contained antibiotic resistant genes, the bacteria that were successfully transfected will survive, and all the other ones that didn't have the plasmid inserted will die. So now we've got a pure culture of bacteria that all contain the plasmid, which contains the gene of interest, the DNA of interest. And now the bacteria just does its thing. So it's just going to start to replicate. The bacteria is going to replicate, and as it's replicating, it's going to produce lots and lots of the gene of interest. It's going to produce lots of the mRNA of interest. And basically what we just did through this process is we just cloned the gene of interest. And that's what we're talking about when we're talking about cloning, at least from a scientific point of view.